Anthoceros, a genus of hornworts that is a group of non-vascular embryophytes in the order Anthocerotales, is widely distributed, mainly in tropical and temperate regions of the world. It belongs to the family Anthocerotaceae. The name Anthoceros means flower horn, which refers to the characteristic horn-shaped sporophytes. Both primitive and advanced characteristics can be observed in Anthoceros. Distribution of Anthoceros. Anthoceros is the largest genus in the family Anthocerotaceae. The genus is represented by about 200 species. Anthoceros is present all over the world. It can be found mostly in temperate and tropical regions. All the species are terrestrial and grow in moist and shady places such as ditches, clay banks, hill slopes, or in the crevices of rock. Some species occur on decaying wood. Some of the common Anthoceros species are Anthoceros crispulus, Anthoceros erectus, Anthoceros himalayensis, Anthoceros shambinus, Anthoceros asamicus, Anthoceros dixiti, Anthoceros sahyadrensis, etc. Gametophyte of Anthoceros. The gametophyte of Anthoceros is a small prostrate thallus. It is the dominant phase of the life cycle. External morphology of the thallus. The plant body of Anthoceros is gametophytic. The gametophyte is a small, prostrate, dorsiventral thallus. It is yellowish-green, or dark green in color. The thallus is generally dichotomously lobed, example Anthoceros fusiformis, but in a few species it is sub-orbicular, example Anthoceros crispulus. The lobes may be divided and have a wavy margin. Due to dichotomously branching, the thallus usually appears as an orbicular or semi-orbicular rosette form. Sometimes the thallus is raised on a thick ascending stalk-like structure, example Anthoceros erectus, or bilobed, example Anthoceros himalayensis, or pinnately branched, example Anthoceros hallii. Dorsal surface. The dorsal surface of the Anthoceros thallus may be smooth, example Anthoceros lavis, velvet-like, example Anthoceros crispulus, or rough with ridges, example Anthoceros fusiformis. In Anthoceros crispulus, many lobed lamellae are present on the dorsal surface. The middle part of the thallus is several layers thick and without a distinct midrib. In some species, the midrib is absent. The mature Anthoceros gametophyte bears horn-like sporophytes on its dorsal surface. Ventral surface. The ventral surface of the Anthoceros thallus bears numerous unicellular, smooth-walled rhizoids. The main functions of rhizoids are to attach the thallus to the substratum and to absorb water and mineral nutrients from the soil. Scales, tuberculate rhizoids, or mucilage hairs are absent on the ventral surface. Many small, rounded, thickened bluish-green spots called mucilaginous cavities are present on the ventral surface. These mucilage cavities are filled with colonies of a blue-green alga-like nastarc. Internal morphology of the thallus. In a vertical cross-section, the Anthoceros thallus shows a very simple structure without any internal differentiation of tissues. The entire thallus is composed of uniform, thin-walled, parenchymatous cells except for the epidermis, which contains comparatively smaller cells. The thallus is several layers thick in the middle region. The thickness of the thallus varies in different species and is 6 to 8 cells thick in Anthoceros lavis, 8 to 10 cells thick in Anthoceros punctatus, and 30 to 40 cells thick in Anthoceros crispulus. The outermost layer of the thallus is the upper epidermis. The surface cells, that is epidermal cells, are regularly arranged. These cells have large chloroplasts and are smaller in size. Each cell of the thallus contains a single large chloroplast. The chloroplast is discoid or oval-shaped with a large pionoid, that is a characteristic feature of the class Anthoceratopsida, in the center. The pionoid is actually formed by the accumulation of 25 to 50 disc-shaped or spindle-shaped bodies. Like green algae, starch grains are synthesized at the periphery of the pionoid in Anthoceros. This shows the algal ancestry of the anthocerotales, order of anthoceros. Also, the number of chloroplasts per cell varies in different species. In Anthoceros personae, each cell contains 2 chloroplasts, but in Anthoceros hallii, the number may be 4 to 8. A single nucleus is present in each cell very close to the chloroplast. There are no air chambers or pores in Anthoceros thallus. Instead, intercellular mucilage cavities are present on the ventral surface of the thallus. These are formed due to the breakdown of the cells, schizogenously. In some species, such as Anthoceros lavis and Anthoceros himalayensis, the mucilage cavities are absent. The mucilage cavities open on the ventral surface through a narrow slit or pore called the slime pore. Each slime pore contains 2 bean-shaped guard cells with thin walls. The guard cells are non-functional. They do not control the size of the pores. As a result, the pores remain completely open. Nastarc, a blue-green alga, invades these mucilage cavities through the slime pores and forms a colony in these cavities. The cavities containing Nastarc colonies can be seen to the naked eye as small, deep blue-green spherical spots on the ventral surface of the thallus. The lowermost cell layer of the thallus is the lower epidermis. A few cells of the lower epidermis extend to develop the smooth-walled rhizoids.